If I want to talk about momentum, what is momentum? Physics in particular is about how things move and interact with each other, and superheroes do that all the time. So is Santa Claus a superhero? I think is a great question, because you have to take it from two perspectives. One is his superpowers. With Santa Claus and getting around the world as quickly as he does, to me, the natural thing to start thinking about is how you bend space and time. Well, you actually stretch space. You shrink the space in front of you, stretching the space out behind you. You then move to where you want to go and then let space go back where it is. So one of the other fun things is getting into houses with and without chimneys.
I'm not accustomed to entering people's homes through the door, but you have no chimney.
This is a little Ant-Man-ish. You imagine him shrinking or expanding or doing different things as he goes in and out. We know matter can't be created nor destroyed unless you turn it into an altered form like energy. So unless Santa Claus was becoming incredibly dense, when he shrunk to get into the chimney, that matter has to turn into energy so there'd be big bright explosions. And then when he expanded, he'd have to suck in the energy from somewhere. The other fun thing is getting all the presents into the bag. There, I like to think of that again as another space-time problem, right? If Santa Claus's bag is actually four-dimensional, the bag itself could be the three-dimensional opening to a four-dimensional space, right? And the space could be much bigger than the opening. So Santa Claus knowing whether you've been bad or good is another kind of interesting one. I figure you can go a couple of ways with this superpower. One is, if he's warped space and time, he's always had access to modern technology, and we're all worried about the spy satellites right now. So maybe he's just using the spy satellites at all points to, you know, basically spy on everybody. Santa Claus is a superhero in that he is fighting against some of the, you know, negativity and bad things just in general that we focus on, and he's bringing kind of a joy and a goodness, and he celebrates that idea of giving. He doesn't have an arch enemy, so he's not in that classic superhero mode, but he is saving us in some ways, which makes him, I think, a superhero.